Hello everyone, welcome to this video lesson. In this video lesson, we would like to find out the numerical value of the Poisson ratio for a perfect elastic body. Before going to that, first of all, we shall remember back what's the definition of Poisson's ratio. Poisson's ratio is defined as the ratio of lateral strain that happens in a wire with respect to the longitudinal strain. Let us first try to understand what is the meaning of this. So if we have a wire fixed to a rigid support, a thin wire, and if we have applied a force at the bottom like this, this creates a strain along the length because the length of the wire increases by a small value delta L. So the strain along the length is nothing but equal to delta L by L. Simultaneously, the thickness of the wire also reduces and a strain is created along the breadth. That kind of a strain is perpendicular to the longitudinal strain or length. That's called something like lateral strain. So the ratio of lateral strain, that is change in the breadth of the wire to its original breadth, with respect to the longitudinal strain, that is ratio of change in the length to its original length, is called something like Poisson's ratio. We want to calculate the value of this Poisson ratio for a perfect elastic body. So we need to know, what do you mean by a perfect elastic body? Let us try understanding that first. So what do you mean by a perfect elastic body? A body is said to be perfectly elastic if it is able to regain its original state 100% when we have removed the applied external force. That means whatever may be the initial dimensions that the body has, whatever the final dimensions are equal to its initial dimensions itself, because it is able to regain its original state 100%. So I can say, for a perfect elastic body, final volume of the body is nothing but equal to its initial volume. Or in the other way, change in the volume of the body is equal to zero. First of all, how can you get the volume of a wire? The body is nothing but equal to wire. So I can say volume of the wire is area of cross section multiplied by the length of the wire. Assuming this wire is having some radius r, assuming the area of cross section is circular, area of cross section is pi r square. Let L is the length of the wire here. Now I want to calculate the change in the volume with respect to the original volume. For this, I am going to use the errors and approximation concept that we have learned in the first year. Delta V by V equal to delta pi by pi. Of course, that's equal to zero because pi is a constant. That's not going to change. 2 into delta R by R, because the power is 2. As per approximation, and delta L by L. Being the body is perfectly elastic, delta V by V equal to 0. Pi is a constant, so it won't change. So 2 into delta R by R plus delta L by L equal to 0. That implies 2 into delta R by R equal to minus delta L by L. That implies delta R by R divided by delta L by L. I will keep a negative sign with delta R by R because the length increases in extension, whereas the breadth increases nothing but a decrease, equal to something like half. So what you have got, half on the right hand side is nothing but the ratio of delta R by R, which can be also similar to that of the delta B by B, breadth, to the delta L by L. Of course, we are having a negative sign, which tells you that one is extension, L length is extension and the breadth is decreasing, which is nothing but equal to the definition of our Poisson's ratio itself, is equal to half. Therefore, for a perfect elastic body, Poisson's ratio sigma is equal to 0.5. So it cannot be more than 0.5, because there is no body that is more than perfectly elastic. In fact, there is no body that is perfectly elastic itself. Therefore, for all real time bodies, that means which are not actually perfectly elastic, Poisson's ratio has to be less than that of 0.5. It cannot be even 0.5 itself, because there is no body that is perfectly elastic. And of course, Poisson's ratio is greater than 0, but it will be less than 0.5. Therefore, for any body, sigma, Poisson's ratio cannot be greater than 0.5. It has to be either 0.5 if it is a case of a perfectly elastic body. Otherwise, it has to be less than that of 0.5. That's it. Thank you for watching. Keep coming back for more and more video lessons. Thank you.